Hello guys, we are here back with Marcella, the journey of a brave woman. She's here, she's leaving tomorrow, and we made a video talk about the revolving, and it was like, why not talk about her trip to London and about fashion, as she's very fashionable person. I was like, let's talk about that with her. Where you're from, what happened?
I'm from Peru, and I moved to America when I was 20 years old. The same year that I moved to America and I was attending college, I had a car accident. I have a spinal cord injury and also a above the knee amputation.
How long are you in a wheelchair?
Well, I have been in a wheelchair for 16 years.
So how was your journey here to London?
My journey to London was nice, was amazing. I love Europe.
Okay, we did a photo shoot yesterday. I think it was your first photo shoot, yeah?
Yeah, we did a photo shoot for designer
Gunda Hafner. Her new collection, yeah. That is fall, autumn. And how was that for you?
I think it was amazing to try her pieces because her style is very similar to mine. The fabrics, the designs, very modern, chic, contemporary. I love it. And so I really love having a photo shoot with her clothes.
Yeah, we need to say thank you also for Piotr, the photographer.
Yeah.
For your first experience, what shall we say, that you're going to be a model from now on?
No, actually, I really like fashion. Some people think that women in wheelchairs, they don't like to be fashionable. Well, that's wrong. You know, woman is a woman, and we like to be fashionable, we like to be pretty, we like to feel good in our skin. So, and sometimes clothes is important, and having the right clothes is important. It's good to work with designers that are willing to make a difference in people with disabilities. The fashion industry, we see that there's not many.
In this case, Gunda, she comes and she talks to us. She sees what we need, you know, our necessities, and she wants to make something that is great, that stand up, but it's also comfortable and modern. You also came to my show,
yeah.
The Fashion's Finest. So how this kind of bites you, and now it is in your blood, and now you're just going to be a superstar, a Gisele Bündchen from Peru, and, you know, she came to the panel, fashion show, photo shoot, and how is that is going to move from here on in your life?
No, actually, I enjoy fashion shows. I haven't been in many, but it was like an honor for me to be here and see Samantha rocking the runway, and see Madeline too, as a model, really, you know. There wasn't a disability there. I mean, they weren't seeing the wheelchair. They were seeing a woman with a nice dress, you know, walking or rolling, proud of herself. Samantha is paving the way for other women that wants to be a model, you know, that wants to be on the runway.
And trying to make people want to be,
yeah,
a model.
And so I think that if she has that gift and those opportunities that life and God has given her, she should continue doing it and, you know, help others. Like, she helped me, you know what I mean? I wasn't expecting it. You know, through her, I met an amazing designer, which is Wanda, her team. And I learned about it. I mean, I'm not the best to post, you know, and in the end, it's not about a pretty face, it's about what you give to the camera.
And you are amazing.
Yeah,
and it was pretty nice, that now you are, because she does the rewalk, she does her traveling, and she does a little bit of fashion, because she shows the things that she wears normally, and now she's open to the fashion as well, you know. So it's one thing more that she can talk about, talk to the designers, and it's like she said, show that we don't have any difference.
Most people think that because we're in a wheelchair, they have to be a special clothes that they need to make, and they think that is a lot of work, but it's not. It's just the same thing that you're doing for someone that is walking. It's the
sometimes
same thing.
Yeah, a few things. But it's not difference when you need to make a plus size or some trousers for a man, woman, or sometimes you put three pockets in and some trousers and another ones you don't.
Yeah.
It's designers, it's different, it's fun, it's play, yes, and colorful.
This talk is going now for the fashion designers, is that we use your clothes, and when we use your clothes, we're not showing it to ourselves or to our mirror only. We are selling to our friends, to our family, because they're gonna say, oh, I love that. I love that t-shirt. I love that pin. Where do you get it? We are also part of the fashionable world. You know what I mean?
We need to normalize the system. I'd like you to leave us with a nice message to empower us to be more brave, be happier, to be a better life. What would be your message?
I make my days better because I choose to wake up with a positive attitude. I try to, like, even though I'm suffering from so much pain, or I woke up with so much pain, or something is not going the way it is, I try to put that behind it and keep pushing, keep going and focus. Think about the good things that you have. Positive attitude is a plus. Keep moving forward, like force yourself to do good, to be good, to do it when you don't want to, because I went through that, you know? And also try new things. And one more thing, say yes to your opportunities, because from every opportunity that you take, you learn something new, and that is going to build you. That is gonna be your personality, yourself. So always say yes. It doesn't matter if you don't like it or not. Do it, try it, as long as it doesn't kill you.
Really be grateful, embrace your opportunities, leave your comfort zone.
Yeah. Love yourself, accept yourself. As I'm getting older, I'm just understanding more. You know, things will get better.
Guys, we're going to leave you here with this wonderful message from Marcela. Thank you for your time.
Yeah.
Follow Marcela on Instagram. That I'm sure you're going to get so inspired. Love you guys. See you soon.
Bye. Thank you.